folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the absolute pleasure of showing you that you haven't got to spend a lot of money to get awesome effects these days for your guitar. With the help of Big Top Effects, an awesome new pedal company here at PMT, where we tick every single box. There's fuzzers, like you heard. I can't stop playing this fuzz. It gives you so much heat under your fingers, it gives you confidence, it gives you sustain, and it puts a smile on your face. I love a good fuzz, especially when it's nice and cheap. There's boosts, there's compressors, there's overdrives, there's distortions, there's a chromatic tuner, which I'm going to show you guys now. This is the tuner. It's wonderful, it's small, it's black, and it's sleek, stylish, and sexy, because I'm going to put it on the floor and actually use it to tune for this video. There's flanges, there's chorus effects, there's time-based effects, there's a really cool reverb with lots of different sounds and soundscape effects in there, as well as regular reverbs. There's a delay. There's a looper, and yeah, they're not a lot of money at all. If you want to get your hands on any of them, all linked in the description box down below. Let's get into it. I'm playing my Kramer Pacer into a Boss Katana just off camera, mic'd up with an SM57. The time-based effects will be going into the effects loop, the rest will be going into the front. There'll be some clean, there'll be some dirt. Let's get into it. I'm going to go back to the fuzz. Let's start with the compressor. I'm going to start in the way in which I would set it out on my pedal board. So, compressors, boosts, overdrives, distortions, then into the time-based effects, modulation effects, then end with the time-based effects, and then the looper. Also, there's a power supply, a Big Top FX generator, which has tons of outputs, but not only that, there's also a USB output as well, so you can charge your phone and stuff through the power supply on your pedal board and any other kind of device you want with that kind of thing, but yeah, I'd use it for my phone. Again, not a lot of money, small and discreet. You can turn the lights on and off, which is awfully handy, but yeah. Everything's powered with that right now. Cool. So this is the tightrope compressor. As the name suggests, Big Top. They're all aptly named after some kind of circus theme. My personal favorite is the chromatic tuner. That's the only one that hasn't got a circus theme, but yeah. This is a compressor. Do you know what a compressor does? It compresses the signal. So it brings up the lows and pulls down the highs to make everything one beautiful unison signal almost. So this is without it. So I could pick as light as I want without it, and notes kind of get lost. Some notes are quite hard. It's kind of nice having that nuance, but sometimes you just want everything to be the same volume. For one, you want to have that percussive kind of attack. That's where a compressor comes in. Think Corey Wong. Super simple to use. All these pedals are have a very, very small footprint and run off a 9-volt power supply, like I was saying. So there's always space on your pedal board for a Big Top effect. And the controls on the tightrope compressor, there's a little switch up top whether you want a really tight, kind of very percussive, attacky compression. That's loose. You're gonna kind of tighten up and get a bit brighter. A little bit warmer, so that's the little switch up top. There's a level for how loud you want the pedal to be. There's a tone for, do you want a bright or dark sounding compressed tone, and a sensitivity. How sensitive do you want the attack to, the compression to attack your note, and also release it to the regular level. That makes sense. Compression's awesome. Everyone should have a compressor, especially when it's only like 30 quid. Next up, we have the Strongman Booster, which is a wonderful little pink box of awesome. The big control in the middle is the gain for how much boost you want. There's a bass control, a treble control, and a separate volume. Now, a clean boost kind of takes what you already have and just kind of gives it something with a little bit of special seasoning on top. It hasn't got as much gain as an overdrive or distortion. It's just that little special boost to push your tone into the next tonal plateau. So right now, I'm on the dirty channel of the Katana. Sounds awesome, but let's kind of give it a little bit of something something. Thank you. gives it a little bit more sizzle under your fingertips and doesn't alter the sound, say, as much as an overdrive or a distortion. Just kind of gives everything a little bit of a boost up. Turn it down. Pedal too. Again, take your amp to the next tonal plateau, or if you have an overdrive pedal, you can pair this and stack it with a separate overdrive pedal to then make that pedal kind of lift up into the next level that it wasn't previously at. Awesome little booster. So with the strongman booster, the clean boost, say if you were on a clean channel, you won't really hear much effect on your tone besides it just going up in volume ever so slightly and kind of a slight bit of tweak. If you want to add a little bit of something a bit more, you get something like the Big Cat Overdrive, which has one big drive control, a tone control if you want a bright sounding overdrive or a dark sounding overdrive, and a volume, and it's mint. What an overdrive does is it doesn't change your tone, it doesn't change the signal, it just adds something to it, like the strongman booster, but with a bit more overdrive, a bit more grit. It kind of tears it around the edges a bit more, and you can hear that on the clean channel. So this is a straight up clean channel. You still hear that kind of the root of your tone there. This adds some seasoning on it almost. If you have got a clean amp and you want to dirty it up, you wouldn't buy an overdrive. You'd change that signal completely and put a distortion in. So here we have the Fire Eater distortion. This is the straight up into the amp. That's a damn good distortion for not a lot of money. I know it's got quite a quiet ground floor as well, so normally cheaper distortions. When you're not playing, you can hear the hiss and you can hear the sizzle. This is pretty quiet with the volume down. Very quiet, in fact. Let's crank it. Only a tiny bit of hit. So one big drive control, a tone control for how bright or how dark you want it to be, and a level for how loud you want it to be to make it in unison with your signal. Let's play with the tone now. That sounds bloody mint. That chug's like... What if that's not even enough for you? Then you'll have to try a fuzz, won't you? Next up we have the Creepy Clown Fuzz, which also has a gain, tone and level control. This is going to the clean channel, and it's class as fellow. It makes you pull a face like a proper beautiful thing. Now the cool thing with this is, like me personally, I'm not a fuzz guy. I don't really use a fuzz in my day-to-day life, so I don't want to spend a lot of money on a fuzz. So besides being perfect for beginners out there and getting their first pedal board, these are also great pedals for the people that want a little novelty pedal that they don't want to spend a lot of money on, just want to scratch the itch, or you want to play some fuzz, spend 30 quid and get a Creepy Clown Fuzz from Big Tower Effects. That's what I'm doing. It's got a very quiet noise floor, so that's a fuzz max. And there's no hum, there's no hiss, there's no nothing. Obviously when the pickups are turned up, there's a bit of noise, but usually there's a bit something something. Not with this. So awesome. Let's get into the modulation effects now. This is the Candy Floss Chorus, and it's a chorus pedal, so it makes everything sound absolutely mint. Three super simple controls, the big control in the middle, how fast you want the chorus warble to be, there's a depth control for how deep you want that warble to be, and a level for volume. Be nice and subtle if you want as well. So what if you want to get all 80s, like what I love? Yeah. that was the Candy Floss Chorus. Let's move on next to the Acrobat Flanger. So my favorite riff of all time features a flanger. So let's see how the Big Top Acrobat Flanger copes with this. Pretty good if you ask me. I like flanders for a couple of reasons. The first one being unchained, obviously, but the second one, to use it as a novelty, like say at the end of a song, if you're like... Big chord at the end. Kind of gives you that awesome bit of gravitas. Right, let's get into the Acrobat a little bit more. For anyone that cares, these are my unchained settings. On the Acrobat flanger, again, the big control in the middle is the rate, how fast you want that flange to be. There's a switch up top, which goes between hard and soft, two different kinds of sine wave almost within the flanges. You want it intense, you want it less intense. There's also a range and a color control, so you can really kind of tweak this flange to your perfect flanging needs. Let's go between hard and soft for first now there. That's hard, quite metallic. Flanders are an interesting thing. Sometimes it's great, sometimes it's not. Soft setting. I'd use it in the soft setting if I was you. And with a clean tone. Ah. Flanders are fun. I love a good flange. It's chewy. And you do this a bit as well. You get the idea. That's the Acrobat flanger. This is the Juggler Reverb, and it's the most intense, let's say, pedal out of all the Big Top lineup, because there's 9 different settings of reverb you can choose within the Juggler Reverb. 2 controls up top is the decay, how long you want the length of your reverb to last, the tail of it, and the mix. In the middle, it's kind of half and half, you're still getting some signal through. When you start going over halfway, it becomes more reverb than signal. So that's all the way, it's just reverb. Quite a fun little effect. If you're into that kind of thing. But with the reverbs effects themselves, the tones themselves, And they go from standard, hall, plate, spring, room, all the usual suspects. That's a lot of reverb. Two quite interesting flanging and chorus ones. So the signal isn't actually getting flanged, it's just the reverb has a flanger modulation effect on it. It's brilliant. The tile. It's kind of like a very small plate, a metallic kind of ring to it. There's lo-fi, which is pretty funky. And a ducking, which is... that kind of thing. It's awfully funky and it works great with distorted tones too. So you can pretend you're sound checking in an empty stadium. You can't be subtle, but you also do this. And that's the awesome juggler reverb. I should have mentioned the reverb was in the effects loop of the Boss, as is the trapeze delay. Wonderful little delay pedal, does what it says on the tip. Do you want to hear your guitar sound again, but slightly after you've played it, and then again after, but it slightly gets quieter? Nice, warm kind of delay loveliness. Then the trapeze artist delay is for you. Echo control, top left. It controls how loud you want the delay to be. Right in the middle, how quick do you want it? Slow. Fast even. Almost slapback-ish. Or a slow delay, like again if you're in Def Leppard or something. On the right-hand side, the feedback controls how many repeats you want. Infinite, like that, or say one or two. You can do like a... that's one repeat there, like a Brian May kind of. Just like that, you got Brighton Rock right there for like 30 quid. It's mint. Check it out. And last but certainly not least, back to the floor, we have the Ringmaster Looper, which is a loop pedal. And all you need to do is control how loud you want the loop to be when it's playing back with that single control. Tap it once to record, twice to stop, once again to overdub, press it twice and hold down the second time to delete. But yeah, it's a looper and it's mint. It's super easy to use, has 24-bit processing, there's also USB input on the side, so you can drag and drop some of your favorite loops onto this and use it live, or if you've recorded something that you quite enjoy, save it for later on your computer via USB. And that's a quick overview of the Big Top Effects exclusive to us here at PMT. Let us know what you think down below in the comments, and like I say, they're all linked in the description box down below so you can get yourself one. I kind of want the whole set because for the price, I think for all of them, it's cheaper than like a Strymon or something, which is absolutely ridiculous. Well, some variants of Strymon, it is quite expensive still, but you know what I mean. I think they're fantastic. We want to know what you think as well. I can't wait for you to try them as well. There'll be plenty in your local PMT store. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to us here at PMTVUK for more guitar and music-related content. We're playing music today on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.